Hey everyone, welcome back to Chip Stock Investor. We're going to be talking about Fortinet today.
And just a quick reminder, we have a lot of cybersecurity coverage over on Semi Insider. Check the link in the video description below. Besides Fortinet and the other big cybersecurity company PurePlays, we've been talking a lot about the cnapp landscape and how investors can capitalize on that. cnapp, Cloud Native Application Protection Party.
Did you just change the acronym?
I did. I changed it. The last P is actually platform, but I think party is way better.
It does sound way better.
Anyways, Semi-Insider. Check us out. We have weekly live events, all of our research, discussions on what we're buying, and most importantly, the why behind it all.
In this video, we're going to be talking about these three key points. Network security is more important than ever. Cybersecurity is a big deal. Fortinet is back in all-out growth mode, and we'll do some updates on our valuation for Fortinet. And when we're talking about Fortinet and network security in all-out growth mode, that's that leftmost bubble, over $65 billion spent in that specific part of the industry, part of the much bigger cybersecurity industry as a whole, $215 billion in 2024, and it's expected double-digit percentage growth over the next 5 to 7 years.
Yeah, and we'll linger on this for just a moment longer because, as you may know, much has been said about the demise of the hardware-based firewall. That's the type of device that back in the day used to protect traffic coming into and going out of, let's say, an office building. But those hardware-based firewalls are actually more important than ever before, and there's a lot of overlap with cloud security because data centers, a big deal. It's not just about the cloud anymore, but a lot of AI applications getting built and deployed from the cloud. So there's a lot of overlap here with application security, mobile security, endpoint, identity. So these lines are really not so cut and dry like we have displayed on this chart, but like Kasey said, the big takeaway here is network security is still very important and expected to grow at a double-digit pace along the overall cybersecurity space.
And because Fortinet provides so much hardware and network security, this is where they focus primarily in the cloud and enterprise. Last bottoms late 2023, and we're just at the beginning of a new growth cycle.
Yeah, that's right. So let's break this down a little bit more because we discussed especially the second half of 2023 and most of 2024, Fortinet overall continued to grow just a little bit, at times just a very low single digit pace. And the reason why was because the hardware component of the business was shrinking. But here's a graphic showing the overall revenue. The segment of this chart in red is the hardware component of Fortinet, so things like firewalls and network equipment. And then the blue is their service revenue. So that's like the software and services. And just by way of reminder, the way Fortinet's business model tends to work is they sell the network hardware to their customers, the customers install that hardware, and then later on, the services and software get turned on. So the hardware is a bit cyclical. You can see a typical every year from Q4 to Q1 of the new year, there's that seasonality in the red bar where revenue declines from Q4 to Q1. This year was no different, but hardware very much in year-over-year growth mode now. And that's a great leading indicator for the services segment, potentially picking up pace later this year and definitely into 2026.
Here's the financial results for this most recent quarter. You can see just over $1.5 billion in Q1, up from $1.35 in Q1 of 2024. That results 13.8% year-over-year change.
And if it interests you, just below the overall revenue, you can see the product revenue, the firewalls and networking hardware. See again, they're starting in Q3 2023. The cyclical downturn started and lasted all the way through Q3 of 2024, but we're now back in year-over-year growth. And Fortinet management really wanted to highlight the fact that we are really at the beginning stages of a refresh cycle for these products. And they expect that this growth rate could accelerate a bit later on this year and into 2026, as a lot of hardware needs to be refreshed that's been sitting around since pre-pandemic. And then some of the equipment that was installed during the pandemic in 2020 and 2021 also up for a refresh cycle as well. That's good for the hardware business and especially for the long-term momentum of that services revenue segment.
Cash flow statement, get net income, had a nice healthy growth up from $300 million to $433 million in net income. And then free cash flow up significantly as well, $783 million in Q1, up from just over $608.
Yeah, that was a record free cash flow print. And a big reason for that, you can see a year ago in Q1, cash flow from operations, not a dramatic increase, but notice the line item there, two lines up from the free cash flow that we have highlighted, purchases of property and equipment, that's capital expenditures. Remember, Fortinet is building out that SASE network, getting some help from Google Cloud to do so. And see the CapEx in Q1 2024 was $222 million. And then the fall off in that this year, just $66.5 million. So they're winding down the biggest part of their infrastructure build out with Google Cloud and now starting to realize early stages of profitability from that new SASE segment.
We did a discussion about this earlier this year about the top four cybersecurity companies and put them through this Rule of 40.
As well as a couple other metrics. Rule of 40, please don't ever use this as a buying indicator, but we do want to show you this anyways, just to illustrate the fact that a lot of investors get hung up on just the revenue line item. And when a growth business starts to slow down, as it naturally will, as it gets larger, there's this tendency to think the business is done. But remember, the Rule of 40 has two components to it. It's not just the revenue growth rate, but it also has a lot to do with the profit margins expanding over time. And that's what's happened with Fortinet here. Obviously, 14% revenue growth in Q1 2025. Most investors are going to pass on Fortinet thinking this isn't a growth business, but then completely ignore the other half of a company's growth driver, profit margins. Their EBITDA margin in Q1 was about 31%. So you add the two together, Fortinet still, among all the cybersecurity companies out there, one of the best there is when using this Rule of 40 metric. Just because a business matures and its revenue growth rate starts to decelerate does not mean that the growth story is finished. In fact, it's far from the truth. Profit margin expansion is a key component to a growth business.
Expected guidance for Q2 between $1.59 and $1.65 billion in revenue. And that would, at the midpoint, mean about almost a 13% growth year over year. On the very far right side of the chart, you can see their expected revenue for all of 2025, expected 13.3% year over year revenue growth.
And it was full year guidance that got Wall Street hung up. The reason why it dropped was management outperformed in Q1. Growth for Q2 is a bit higher than expected, but they left the full year guidance unchanged just in case there's some unforeseen hiccups in their growth expectations because of tariffs and trade policy changes, which are a big unknown still at this point. So they left the full year guide alone. They did increase their expected profit a little bit, but it was this uncertainty around the second half of the year that had Wall Street in freakout mode. But remember, these stock price moves tend to be very temporary in nature. Fortinet had a great report and issued some very positive commentary about not just this year, but also 2026 because of that refresh cycle in their hardware business.
So here's our reverse DCF that we did back in February 2025, $2.33 per share. We used a blended trailing 12-month GAAP earnings per share and free cash flow per share. Baked in 30% profit growth over the next 2 years, brought a terminal growth rate of 6.5% thereafter, gave us a fair value of 105 for the stock. It was around 107 on February 7th, 2025. So let's update that to what we see here in May.
So just to give you an idea of what we did, so it still says a per share profit growth for the next 2 years, but really in your head, we didn't want to say like 1 3/4 of a year. Basically, this reverse DCF originally 3 months ago was through the end of 2026. And so this update is still through the end of 2026. So what gets updated here is the trailing 12-month GAAP earnings per share of $2.43, significant year-over-year increase there. And then free cash flow per share, also significant year-over-year increase, $2.68. So blending those two together, $2.56, that higher starting point is what lowers the per share profit growth expectation through the end of 2026 from 30% before down to 25. And then because the stock price has fallen, at least as we speak here today, to the low $90 range, we can also lower the terminal growth rate down to 6%. This is just our estimate of what we think Wall Street is thinking now with the after hours or pre-market drop in Fortinet stock. So the bar has been lowered. Expectations have remained unchanged. So this is basically one of those dips in a company valuation where if you were waiting for a lower bar, an easier bar for the company to clear before making a purchase, maybe this is that time. That's up for you to decide. But this is, for us personally, this is one of those points in time where, you know, hey, outlook is fantastic. Nothing's really changed other than the stock price. If it's a great business with a proven track record, hey, we're interested.